好，各位同事，欢迎大家再来到我们的 Counselling Talk。 咁今日两位嘉宾都嚟过㗎啦，咁我都以为佢哋记得晒我哋啲嘢，原来我哋转咗好多嘢，所以呢剛才差啲唔记得咗 orientate 佢我哋个 studio 而家嘅 setup 係點添。咁原来佢哋都转咗好多嘢喎，上次呢就阿 Brian 嚟讲书啦，咁就嗰时个 title 就係 Hong Kong U 啦，咁呢就而家呢佢又多咗个 title，咁咧就係 Chief Scientific Officer of Hong Kong Genomic Institute。咁其實可能大家對呢個 institute 好陌生，呢個咩嚟嘅咧？係咩出邊咩機構咧？咁樣原來唔係呢個政府嘅嚇，政府全資嘅機構嚟嘅。咁啊呢個非常之重要。咁所以咧今日特登請到兩位嚟咧，都介紹下佢哋嘅工作，新成立嘅 Hong Kong Genomic Institute。咁啊非常之重要。咁可能大家尤其是醫生同事咧，都耐唔中，而家越嚟越多添啦。就係啲 patient 咧，攞住喺其他地方做嗰啲 genomic study 啲 result 就過嚟問我哋。其實望來都唔知係乜嚟嘅，寫就寫到好恐怖啦。咁究竟點樣樣咧？咁今日咧就希望透過 Jasmine 我哋嘅嘉賓咧，就講講呢個話題。咁希望增加我哋對呢個題目嘅認識。咁而家將個時間交俾阿 Brian。等佢介紹今日 topic 同埋今日嘅講者，係 Brian， 唔該曬。
好多謝啊 ，Dr. Chan， 好高興喺咁短嘅時間又可以幫啊 Dr. Chan 你呢度講書，又跟啊 Dr. Chan 學下嘢啦。啱啱佢先教咗我 IT 啊 lab 嘅 design 啊好多嘢嘅咁樣。咁頭先 Dr. Chan 咧就提到 Hong Kong Genome Institute， 我知道啦。阿 Jasmine 咧今日即係有預備到咁，我個工作咧就介紹下 Jasmine Fung 係我同事嚟嘅。咁我識 Jasmine 咧就大概三年前到，佢係 student 嚟嘅。佢嗰陣時係喺 Hong Kong U 讀緊 Bachelor of Biomedical Science， 好成熟、好聰明嘅一個女仔。佢 graduate 咗就嚟問我啊，當中我第時想做 genetic counselor。我話啊，你咁細個就知道 genetic counselor？genetic counselor 呢一樣嘢喺香港都未係好成立嘅喎。佢就已經慢慢可以解釋俾我聽。哦，我知道 genetic counselor 咧唔係醫生嚟嘅。唔係護士嚟嘅，係另外一種工種嚟嘅，做啲嘢好有意義。咁佢講咗好多佢自己個睇法。咁所以我哋嗰陣時咧就喺 Hong Kong 要試下有冇嗰個機會咧，就即係involve Jasmine 多少少，即係去 go through 一啲基本關於 genetic counselling 嘅一啲訓練咁樣。咁 Jasmine 就已經學滿師啦。咁學滿師之後咧，我哋突然間偶遇，原來我哋都見緊同一個機構嘅工，我哋做緊唔同嘅嘢。咁 Jasmine 咧就而家。而家係即係 Hong Kong Genome Institute 嘅 genetic counselor。咁對於頭先啊 Dr. Chan 講嘅嘢，啊 Hong Kong Genome Institute 究竟做啲乜嘢嘢嘅？或者可能大家對即係 genetic counselor 嘅工作即係都好有興趣嘅話咧，我希望咧阿 Jasmine 今日呢個 talk 咧可以俾到少少答案大家。好，咁唔阻大家時間 ，Jasmine 請你開始啦。
我多謝 Dr. Chan 同埋 Dr. Chong 嘅介紹咁樣啦。咁今日咧主要咧都係想分享翻我即係少少嘅經驗嚟嘅啫，係啦，因為即係始終即係 genetic counselling 即係可能喺香港都未必話即係太有認識咁樣嘅。咁我而家即係最主要就想用唔同嘅 cases 啦，就去即係講下即係香港嘅 genetic counselling 係點樣嘅。係啦，咁少少 introduction 關於咩 genetic counselling 啦。咁喺即係by definition 咧，其實咧佢係一個咧去幫助啲人啦或者病人啦去明白同埋去適應一啲即係同 genetic disease 有關嘅一個程序嚟嘅，係啦。咁呢一樣嘢咧，其實就牽涉咗唔同嘅領域嘅，咁包括咧一啲即係如果人呢啲人有一啲基因上嘅情況嘅時候，佢哋即係喺醫療上啦、心理上啦或者家庭上咧，其實咧都會有一個影響。咁 genetic counselors 嘅工作咧，就係去幫呢一啲人去明白同埋去適應嘅。咁佢最主要分咗幾個大範疇啦，係啦。咁關於咧就係即係一開始就係即係去睇下嗰啲屋企人啊，同埋即係佢哋個人嘅醫療嘅history 啦，然之後就去做一啲類似叫 risk assessment 嘅嘢嘅，係啦，即係譬如喺一個 family 入邊，究竟呢一個 family 會唔會係有一個好高嘅機率去有一啲 genetic 嘅 condition 啦？ 咁另外咧就係、是、去 educate 翻呢啲嘅家庭，關於一個即係呢個 genetic condition 係點樣㗎，有啲咩 inheritance 啊，而而家已知有啲乜嘢嘅management plan 啊、prevention 啊等等嘅。咁最尾咧就係即係去 counsel 翻佢關於即係 psychologically 啦，同埋佢哋嗰個唔同嘅 options 啊。因為其實咧，我哋見到即係 genetic disease 佢對一個家庭嚟講咧，佢嗰個影響嘅地方咧都有好多唔同嘅嘢嘅。咁所以咧，我哋咧係俾一啲唔同嘅 information 去，令到咧佢哋去適應，同埋即係去知道佢哋嘅唔同嘅風險啊等等，去作出佢哋認為最適合嘅選擇嘅。係啦，咁所以 genetic counselors 咧就需要有幾種 core skills 嘅，咁包括啦就一啲即係關於 genetics 嘅 knowledge 啦，咁亦都要有一啲好好嘅 communication skills， so that 咧就可以即係 support 到個 patient 同 family 嘅。係啦，咁我因為即係主要咧就跟阿 Dr. Chong 啦，咁佢咧就做 rare disease 嘅，咁所以我自己經驗上比較多咧就係、是、關於 pediatrics 嘅 case， 係啦，咁所以多數咧見咧就係、是、會係一個家庭咁樣，譬如個小朋友係個即係主要個患者啦，咁通常就會係啲爹哋媽咪會一齊嚟，或者有陣時可能一啲家庭係又會一大個家庭嚟，我哋 clinic 咧都會有嘅，係啦。咁其實咧個 genetic counselling 嘅 objective 咧，最主要咧就係去 facilitate 依一個 client 嘅 informed decision making 啦，係啦。咁即係因為其實咧，關於 genetics 或者 genomics 咧，即係喺即係廣大市民啊或者病人入邊咧，其實咧佢哋都有好多唔同嘅問題嘅，係啦。例如啊，我需唔需要做一個 genetic test 啦？然之後做我個報告出咗嚟，咁其實又代表啲咩咧？係啦，咁或者喺即係 pediatrics 方面，即係見到多啲，就係話啊，會唔會話即係會有啲 inheritance？ 即係我想再生小朋友喎，會唔會其實我查個小朋友都有同一樣嘅情況咧？係啦，咁所以 genetic counselors 咧，最主要咧就係去解答翻呢一啲嘅問題嘅，係啦。咁而無論即係嗰個病人佢哋即係聽完呢啲嘅資訊之後，佢哋點樣去做一個 decision 咧？我哋最主要咧就係 support 佢嗰個 decision 嘅。咁呢度咧有三大個 big principle of genetic counselling。咁第一樣嘢咧就係 autonomy 啦，係啦。咁 genetic counselors 咧就好信個病人咧，其實佢哋係有佢哋自己嘅能力去 make the best decision for themselves。係啦，因為即係有陣時可能我哋有一啲genetics 嘅 knowledge 啦，我哋可能會覺得你咁樣做可能會最好喎，即係 based on 一啲 medical 啊或者 genetics 嘅 knowledge。但有陣時咧，我哋發現即係 genetics。即係一啲 genetic condition， 其實佢牽涉個範圍咧就唔係淨係 medical 入邊嘅，咁所以咧其實佢哋可能會要諗下其他方面，例如會唔會有啲屋企嘅因素啊，或者即係社會上其他唔同嘅因素，佢哋要考慮咧，係啦，咁所以咧我哋咧就會俾個自主權，其實就係個家庭自己去決定嘅，係啦，咁同時間啦，我哋亦都應該咧要 be non-judgmental 嘅。係啦，即係無論佢最尾個決定係點咧，我哋咧都應該去接受同埋去 support 佢哋嘅，係啦。咁最尾咧就是、non-directive 啦，我哋咧就好少咧，即係話我哋有已經有一個方向或者一個諗法，而係去即係好強烈咁樣去即係同個 patient 講某一樣嘢嘅。通常咧，我哋就係擺曬哦唔同嘅嘢出嚟啦。呢一個有啲咩好處，有啲咩 risk 啊等等，然之後就等佢哋去做一個 final decision 咯。係啦，咁然之後咧就係、是、關於究竟 genomic medicine 係乜嘢嚟嘅。係啦，咁 genomic medicine 咧就係、是、一個咧而家一直即係 emerging 嘅一個新嘅 discipline 啦，叫做即係比較新嘅 discipline 啦。係啦，咁就係用一啲我哋基因或者叫基因組嘅資料係啦，去擺落個 medical practice 度嘅，咁就睇下可唔可以即係幫助到依啲人士佢哋嘅 clinical care 啦，同埋佢哋嘅 health outcome 嘅。係啦，咁左邊呢個圖咧就係、是、即係 genetics 嘅一啲即係基本嘅科學概念咁樣啦。咁每個人都有23對嘅染色體啦。咁而之後如果你打開咗個染色體，就會一度好似嗰度咁樣 unfold 咗之後咧，就見到即係嗰啲 ATCG 嗰啲最 molecular part of 個 genetics 嘅。咁呢一度咧，我哋就想即係帶出一樣嘢啦，就係話而家其實 genomics 咧喺個即係一個人嘅 life stages 嗰度咧，其實已經喺唔同嘅時間點咧都有一個 involvement 嘅喎。 係啦，咁睇翻啦，即係其實喺一個 B B 真係出世之前咧，其實喺一個懷孕嘅過程度咧，而家已經開始有一啲嘢咧係即係會可以係同 genetics 有關嘅，咁例如啦就係 non-invasive prenatal testing 啦，係啦呢啲咁嘅無創嘅基因檢查咧，其實而家即係香港啊各同埋各世界各地咧都係即係已經有做到噶啦，咁然之後當然亦都可能有一啲係一啲叫 prenatal diagnosis 啦，都係喺即係個 B B 出世之前已經有一個 involvement。咁當個 BB 出咗世之後啦，或者喺一啲小朋友嗰度咧，其實咧個 diagnostic 咧都越嚟越成熟嘅，係啦。咁呢啲大部分咧，我哋就係一啲 Mendelian disorder， 或者我哋叫即係一啲單基因嘅基因改變咁樣樣。咁而家咧即係 genomics 咧就發展得越嚟越越嚟越好啦，咁然之後咧，而家越嚟越多咧，就係關於去到成人或者大青少年期，關於 polygenic risk score 啦。咁呢一啲就係講緊話啊，唔係一個基因導致一個疾病嘅，而係好多唔同嘅細嘅 genetic factors 導致到影響咗有一個 genetic risk 喺度。咁另外就之後後期就多啲 cancer 啦，而而家就再多啲咧就係關於 pharmacogenetics 啊，就係一個人嘅基因嘅 profile 點樣影響佢哋對一啲藥物嘅response 啊等等，係啦。咁右手邊咧有兩個圖嘅，係啦，咁就係講緊話即係嗰個 application 或者嗰個應用啊，喺即係 genomic sequencing 喺即係醫療上啊或者各方面嘅應用。咁你見到啦，呢個 WGS 即係 whole genome sequencing 咧，咁你見到咧佢個 growth 咧係 exponential 嘅，即係而家你講緊而家2021年啦，係啦，咁講緊十年前，其實基本上咧個有 sequence 過嘅人數咧真係好低，由2014年咧就見到咧呢個哇節節上升，越嚟越多咁樣。係啦，咁其中一個原因即係我哋都知道就係即係嗰個 research 啊，或者即係喺醫療上我哋都發現到嗰一個好處係越嚟越多啦。而另外一樣嘢咧就係個 cost 咧係越嚟越低嘅，係啦。咁呢一個係一個 NIH profile 嘅圖咁樣啦。咁你見到咧呢度其實講2001年嘅時候咧係好貴嘅。咁呢度本身有條線啦 ，Moore's law 其實就係一個 prediction 嚟嘅，因為每一樣嘢佢個價錢應該係會越嚟越平咁樣嘅。咁你見到其實咧 genomic sequencing 咧嗰個跌幅咧係遠低於個 Moore's law 嘅。去到而家咧，其實去 sequence 一個 human genome 咧只要$1,000嘅美金，係啦。咁所以咧就即係呢一樣嘢亦都好 greatly facilitate 咗一個 genomic medicine 嘅發展嘅。咁究竟咩係 genetics 同埋 genomics 咧？係啦，因為呢兩個字其實咧就即係好類似啦。咁可能都有啲人士會問啊，咁其實有咩分別咧？咁樣咁 genetics 咧就係講緊一啲關於 genes 嘅 study 啦，係啦。咁所以咧泛指咧就多少少關於係一啲單基因嘅疾病啦，係啦，或者一個基因導致一個疾病嗰個情況嚟嘅。係啦，咁例如即係可能啲比較出名，即係大家都認知㗎啦，例如 cystic fibrosis 啊、Huntington's disease 啊，呢啲咧就一啲典型我哋即係復喺 genetics 嗰度嘅，係啦。咁如果另外一個 genomics 啦，咁其實咧就係講緊個 genome 啊。咁 genome 嘅意思咧就係所一個人入邊所有嘅基因嘅，係啦。咁就即係唔係淨係一個基因啦，係多過一個基因而。再延伸咧，就係關於佢哋 gene 同 gene 或者 gene 同 environment 之間嘅關係。咁所以啲嘢咧就係變咗，除咗係單一嘅咧，就開始有啲 complex disease， 即係可能或者 multifactorial disease 嘅研究咧都開始出嚟啦，係啦。咁樣呢一個咧，因為 genomics 嘅發展啦，咁亦都 open to new possibilities of diagnostic methods 啊、therapies 等等嘅。係啦，咁如果即係用翻個 analogy 嚟講咧 ，genetics 咧就好似一個即係一張食譜咁，教你點樣整一個朱古力蛋糕。係啦，咁如果譬如我 study genetics 就係、是、啊，我想睇翻呢一個朱古力蛋糕嗰個食譜入邊會唔會話啊，我喺嗰個整嗰、那個情況嗰度串錯咗個字，落糖變咗落鹽咁樣啦。係啦，咁如果 genomics 咧就係唔係淨係睇一張食譜啦，就成本烹飪書咁樣去睇嘅，係啦，咁呢個咧就大致上嗰個分別啦，係啦， 咁呢一個咧就係一個可能即係、一個圖啦，就去話到俾大家聽，其實而家我哋有啲咩 technology 係 available 嘅，係啦。咁如果譬如講緊啊，之前 genetics 啊嗰啲咧，就多少少係一啲我哋叫 targeted testing 啊，即係譬如話我懷疑 cystic fibrosis 啦，咁所以我就即係 test CFTR 嗰個 gene 咁樣，咁可能咧就係、做呢一方面嘅 targeted sequencing。咁而家去到發展咧，就越嚟越闊啦，係啦。咁有陣時可能有陣時就會用一啲 NGS panel 啦，係啦。咁就可能有幾十個 gene， 而再多啲咧就係 whole exome sequencing 同 whole genome sequencing。咁基本上咧就係可以 sequence 曬即係身體入邊嘅 genes 嘅，係啦。咁 whole genome sequencing 同 whole exome sequencing 嘅分別係啲乜嘢呢？咁頭先有略略講過啦，即係其實 whole genome， 即係 genome 就係我哋身體入面所有嘅基因。咁其實咧就好似呢一個蘋果咁樣嘅 ，whole genome 咧就係講緊成個蘋果，而 exome 咧就係 part of 個 genome 嚟嘅，係啦。咁如果講翻 percentage 咧，其實咧就係一個 percent 嘅啫，係啦。咁但係咧呢一個 percent 咧，我哋就係暫時認為係最有用嘅一個 percent 嚟嘅，係啦。咁其實咧 ，exome 咧就係、一個我哋叫做係講緊嗰個 part 咧，係會之後變咗做一個 protein 嘅。咁 that's why 我哋先覺得佢係最重要，係啦。咁呢度即係都大概講一講啦，即係 whole genome sequencing 就成個 genome 嘅嘢都會 sequence 咗啦。exome sequencing 就 select 咗呢啲有 protein 嘅 part 去 sequence 嘅，係啦。咁而呢啲 protein 嘅 part 加埋咧，淨係一個 percent 嘅啫。係啦，咁其實佢哋呢兩個 sequencing 咧，主要嘅 techniques 咧都係用緊 next generation sequencing 嘅。咁比較起一啲傳統嘅 genetic test 咧，佢就有一個高啲嘅 diagnostic yield 啦。咁去到而家咧，國際上啊，都即係大概知道係30% 左右嘅。咁佢個 coverage 咧，即係嗰、那個即係佢 cover 到嘅 genes， 當然就比傳統嘅 testing 嘅闊啲啦。咁亦都係因為呢啲 techniques 咧，我哋可以 allow 一啲 gene discovery 嘅。咁但係即係比較起傳統嘅 testing 嚟講咧，咁就即係嗰個問，即係或者嗰個難度咧，已經唔係話我哋sequence 到啦。個而家嗰個難度咧，就去咗做你 sequence 完呢啲 data 出嚟，點樣做一個 interpretation 係啦？因為你睇到嘅嘢越嚟越闊啦，咁所以入邊其實可能有好多 uncertain findings 嘅。咁而呢一樣嘢亦都可能對即係個 counselling 嗰度係有一個影響嘅，因為你要同病人講嘅嘢就越嚟越多啦。即係以前可能啊，我而家幫你安排一個gene 嘅 testing， 因為係好 specific 嘅，你呢啲咁嘅病徵，我哋覺得呢個 testing 最好。咁但係而家咧就變到好闊啦。咁有就即係可能病人話：咁我 expect 我要 test 即係個 result 有啲咩嘅時候，可能佢即係就好話其實即係好 depends on 出嚟嗰個結果係點樣。個 post-test counselling 咧就已經即係變到好，即係同以前有啲唔同咁樣樣咯。係啦，咁當然啦，雖然我頭先講咗越嚟越平啦，但係對比起其他 testing 咧，佢都係即係比較貴嘅。係啦，係咁樣咧。genomic testing 嘅報告入邊，其實佢哋可以同我哋講到啲乜嘢咧？係啦，咁其實咧，我哋如果譬如講緊做一個 genomic testing， 即係無論係 whole genome 啦，定係 whole exome 咧，第一樣嘢咧就係關於一個 primary findings 啊。咁呢一樣嘢即係代表就係話啊，呢一個病人例如佢有啲咩嘅病徵，咁我哋就想因為呢一啲病徵去做呢個 test。咁呢一個咧就係嗰個 primary findings 啦。咁其實咧喺呢幾年啦，即係譬如唔同嘅 organisation， 例如 American College of Medical Genetics 啦 ，ACMG 啦，其實都有出到一啲 standards 或者 guideline 咧，去點樣 interpret 一啲 genomic testing 嘅 findings 嘅。係啦，咁喺佢其實佢哋嗰個 standard guideline 咧就有啲似右上角呢個表咁樣。咁其實咧佢有唔同嘅criteria。咁如果嗰、那個譬如嗰個 genetic change 係 meet 到呢啲 criteria 咧，佢有唔同嘅 strength 咧，就可以幫你做一個 classification。咁呢個 classification 咧，主要咧就分咗五大嘅類別嘅。咁如果係一個報告啦，即係或者我哋即係order 完一個 genomic testing， 佢個報告出嚟咧，咁有陣時會首先啦，可能會揾到一個 positive result。咁個意思咧就即係話我哋揾到一個基因嘅改變咧，我哋認為係解釋得到本身嗰一個嘅病因嘅，係啦。咁而呢個 positive 入邊咧，其實咧就包含咗兩樣嘢嘅。咁嗰個 genetic change 可以係 pathogenic 啦，或者 likely pathogenic。咁其實呢一個呢兩個 category 嚟，對我哋嚟講咧，都係一個 positive finding 嚟嘅。咁即係話喺醫學上，或者喺個基因或者科學上咧，我哋覺得咧都好大機會係嗰個病因噶啦，係啦。咁喺呢一個 scale 嘅另外一邊咧，就是、一個 negative finding 嚟嘅。咁即係我哋揾唔到啲咩特別嘢去解釋得到嗰個病因，係啦。咁因為其實每個人都會有一啲基因嘅改變噶嘛。係啦，咁唔一定每一個基因改變咧，都係同嗰個病有關嘅。咁可能有啲基因改變純粹係啊，即係影響一個人嗰啲唔同嘅面部特徵啊，或者即係嗰啲身高啊、體重啊各方面。咁呢啲如果即係已經有足夠嘅數據話啊，其實同疾病冇關係咧，咁呢一啲咧就會係一啲屬於我哋叫 benign 或者 likely benign 嘅基因改變嘅。咁喺呢兩個 category 中間咧，其實咧有一個好大嘅範疇啦，就係、是、一啲我哋叫 variance of uncertain significance 或者叫 VUS 啊。咁就即係話，因為其實咧我哋嗰個基因嘅發展咧都發展得好快嘅。咁而家我哋就即係雖然嗰個我哋可以做到好多嘅 sequencing 啦，咁但係我哋亦都唔係了解曬每一樣嘢噶嘛。係啦，咁所以中間有一啲咧，我哋就即係可能啲基因改變咧，我哋唔可以係呢兩邊嘅。咁所以中間呢一部分咧，全部咧都係叫 uncertain significance。咁你見到啦，佢唔係一個 linear scale 嚟嘅，係啦。咁其實 uncertain significance 嗰度咧係包咗好多嘅基因嘅，係啦。咁所以咧 genetic counselors 或者即係唔同嘅 scientists 咧，其實咧喺呢一方面咧就係、是、一啲 genomic testing 帶嚟嘅一啲可能要 handle 嘅事情啦。咁除咗 primary findings 之外咧，都仲有 secondary findings 嘅。咁、那個意思係乜嘢咧？就係、是、話啊，除咗個 referral indication 之外，呢、這、一個 genomic testing 咧，因為佢睇曬所有基因啦，咁所以咧喺個分析嘅途中，其實係有機會揾到一啲同你 referral indication 唔關事，但係已經知道係同其他疾病有關嘅。係啦，咁呢一樣嘢咧，就例如即係我亂講，例如係一啲 cancer risk 啊，或者即係如果即係好即係 typical 或者嘅 example 就係可能係 BRCA 嘅 genes 啊咁樣，咁呢一啲咧其實report 咧就要同即係嗰個病人咧去做即係要傾嘅係啦，因為其實我哋 counselling 咧有要做 pre-test counselling， 即係你喺做 test 之前，你要明白到嗰個 test 入邊其實佢包含咗啲乜嘢啦。咁如果譬如話，因為呢個 test 我哋知道佢有機會會 bring about 一啲我哋叫 secondary findings 嘅話，咁其實佢哋想唔想知咧？有啲人係想知喎，因為佢你可以做到 screening 啦。咁但係亦都有啲人可能話我唔想知啊，因為呢一個係會俾到我好大嘅 psychological stress。係啦，咁呢一樣嘢就係 genetic counselors 要喺 pre-test counselling 嗰度講得好清楚，同埋即係呢一樣嘢亦都係我哋覺得係好重要嘅，因為嗰個 implication 已經唔係淨係話即係即係因為佢有好多其他嘅嘢可以發生啦。咁所以咧 genetic counselling 咧就喺呢一度咧係好就好需要嘅，咁同埋咧亦都要好小心去即係喺個 evaluation 入邊咧都係好小心先可以做到嘅。咁之後咧就關於即係 genetic counselling in genomics era 啦。咁頭先即係都有講到啦，我哋嗰啲 technology 咧而家就越嚟越好啦。咁由一啲可能 single gene 嘅 testing， 慢慢咧就 expand 到咧即係 whole genome sequencing 咧都越嚟越普及啦。係啦，咁呢一樣嘢其實對 genetic counselling 有啲咩 implication 咧？第一樣嘢咧就係、是、關於個 broader testing approach 係啦。咁以前嘅話咧，即係如果譬如你 suspect 佢某一個 genes 嘅話，就淨係做嗰個 single gene 啦。如果譬如 test 出嚟 negative， 就去第二個 gene 啦咁樣係啦。咁而但係而家咧 whole genome sequencing 就可以一次過做曬所有嘢。咁所以一個 test 咧其實係可以 for multiple conditions 嘅。咁而除咗 for multiple conditions 咧，亦都可以係 for multiple use 嘅。係啦，咁我哋譬如喺醫院多少少咧，就係做一啲 diagnostic testing 啦。咁但係其實 with 呢啲 whole genome sequencing 咧，有好多唔同嘅嘢都可以俾到出嚟嘅喎。即係除咗做 diagnostic test， 其實佢可以係一個 predictive test， 或者亦都可以係一個 carrier test、pharmacogenetic test， 甚至乎而家咧就即係越嚟越多或者都會普及嘅咧，就 direct to consumer testing。咁所以你見到佢嗰個 application 啊，同埋即係佢嗰個 information load 咧，就越嚟越多嘅，係啦。咁所以咧 ，genetic counselors 咧就好需要咧，即係將呢一啲咁 complex 嘅 information 咧，去話俾個 client 聽嘅， 係啦，咁從而因為其實本身喺 genetic counselling 入邊，其中一樣嘢就係要令到嗰個 client 去做一個 informed choice， 係啦。咁但係而家咧就好 information overload 咁樣嘅，係啦，因為太多嘅 information 啦，咁而嗰啲 client 又要消化咁樣，咁呢一個就係我哋叫做少少轉變啦，即係越嚟越多，即係因為其實 genetic counselling 個發展都係一直改變緊嘅，係啦，因為以前嘅 practice 同而家嘅 practice 咧都有啲唔同嘅，係啦，咁而家咧就多咗少少關於呢啲 complex 嘅 information。咁除咗話點樣去做 informed choices 之外咧，另外咧都仲有關於呢一啲嘅 number of results 啊。因為以前即係可能一直做 single gene 嘅話咧，嗰、那個揾到 VUS 或者 根本就即係或者未必會有 incidental findings 呢一樣嘢出現啦。咁有 genomics testing 嘅時候咧，就多咗好多呢一啲咁樣嘅 uncertainties 或者一啲 additional information 嘅。咁 genetic counselors 咧都係要去做呢一樣嘢，就係、是、即係有即係可能個 session 入邊就會變咗有好多唔同嘅 information 要俾個 patients 嘅。係啦，咁從而即係喺我頭先講嗰啲嘢啦，咁其實每一樣嘢其實都有機會咧影響到唔同嘅 ethical 啦、psychological 啦同埋 social impacts on 個 patients 嘅，係啦。咁之後接住落嚟咧，我就會 present 四個 case 啦，咁就主要就係想 illustrate 翻 genetic counselling in Hong Kong 嘅，係啦。咁第一個 case 啦，咁其實呢個 case 都係兒童醫院嘅 case 嚟嘅。係啦，咁就一個十三日大嘅 BB 咁樣啦，咁就 for genetic evaluation of improper anus 啦，同埋一個 suspected family history of Waardenburg syndrome 係啦，咁呢個 BB 咧本身咧就係即係 full term 出世啦，產前嘅檢查所有嘢都 unremarkable 嘅，咁亦都冇做任何嘅 prenatal testing 啦，係啦，咁嗰、那個improper anus 咧就係、是、一出世嘅時候見到嘅，咁冇其他 structural abnormalities， 然之後喺嗰陣時咧個 hearing screening 咧都係即係冇特別嘅，咁唯獨是咧就係、是、關於個 physical examination 啊，啲 neonatal doctors 咧就見到佢有依啲嘅 features 啦，咁 sclera 係白色嘅 ，iris 啡色啦，冇 heterochromia， 即係佢兩隻眼個眼珠係一樣色嘅，係啦，咁然之後 bilateral red reflex 啦。咁其中一樣嘢就係話佢個眼距比較闊，同埋佢個鼻係比較 flat 同埋 broad 嘅，係啦。咁而呢一個 features 咧，其實咧就好似佢嘅媽媽同埋佢一個六歲大嘅家姐嚟嘅。咁呢一啲嘅 features 咧，就覺得佢會唔會同 Waardenburg syndrome 有關咧？咁樣。咁基於呢一個 referral 咧，我哋首先咧本身就安排咗去做一個 karyotype 啦，同埋 qPCR 去睇翻啲染色體嘅。咁我哋就個結果出嚟咧，其實係 normal 嘅，係啦。咁我哋咧就有諗過啊，會唔會其實可以即係做一啲 additional test 咧咁樣？咁我哋咧就有諗過啊，我哋不如同個家長去傾下會唔會做 whole exome sequencing 啦咁樣。咁主要譬如做 whole exome sequencing 咧，呢度就 illustrate 到即係一個 test 係可以做到兩樣嘢嘅，係啦。咁第一樣嘢就係關於佢個 family history of Waardenburg syndrome 啦，另外就 improper anus 啦。咁其實本身 improper anus 咧就即係可能 genetic component 咧就唔係話真係好強嘅，係啦，因為我哋做咗啲chromosome changes 咧，即係都冇任何嘅嘢啦。係啦，咁但係因為佢有埋嗰、那個suspected 嘅 Waardenburg syndrome， 我哋就覺得可以藉埋呢個機會咧，兩樣嘢都一齊睇咁樣樣啦。係啦，咁其實咩 Waardenburg syndrome 咧？其實咧就係、是、一 group 嘅 genetic conditions 嚟嘅，咁主要咧就是、影響一啲即係色素嘅改變同埋 hearing loss 係啦。咁呢啲色素嘅改變咧，可以喺個眼睛啦、頭髮或者皮膚度發生嘅。咁所以你個 physical exam 頭先就好 stress 就 on 即係嗰啲sclera 啊、iris 嘅 color 咁樣啦，係啦。咁大部分嘅人士咧都可能係即係 normal hearing 嘅，但係咧即係一啲 profound 嘅 hearing loss 都可以 occur 嘅。係啦，咁而嗰個 features 咧，其實係好唔同嘅，喺就算喺同一家人入邊啦，都可以好唔同嘅，係啦。咁另外一啲嘅 features 就關於一啲 facial features 啊，或者 congenital abnormalities 啦，係啦。咁呢一張相就係即係喺internet 嗰度攞嘅，係啦。咁你見到呢個小朋友個眼距都係比較闊啦，而佢係藍眼睛嘅，係啦。咁如果講翻 Waardenburg syndrome 嘅 genetics 咧，佢主要咧有四大種嘅，係啦，咁主要咧就係 distinguishable by 佢 physical 同埋 genetic cause。咁佢42000人入邊有一個， 咁你睇到呢個 table 咧，其實即係雖然佢話有四個 type 啦，咁其實佢每個 type 入邊都有啲 subtype 嘅，係啦。咁所以你見到佢個 gene 室嘅數目咧都係多嘅，而個 inheritance 咧可以係 AD 可以 AR 嘅。係啦，咁隔離呢度有個 news 啦，咁唔知大家有冇見過呢一樣嘢啦？因為咧係應該係上年年尾咧，突然間係 internet 好出名嘅一個喺Indonesia 嘅一個 tribe 嘅相嚟嘅。咁其實呢班人咧，即係呢個 tribe 咧就有一個 Waldenburg syndrome 嘅，係啦。咁呢一個就係佢啲相，你見到即係呢個男仔同呢個女仔，佢哋眼珠唔同色啊！呢一樣嘢咧，其實就係一個 hallmark features of Waldenburg syndrome 嚟嘅，就係啦。咁然之後咧，而家就講翻究竟嗰陣時個 genetic counselling 係點樣嘅？咁嗰陣時咧，我哋就喺即係嗰個 bedside 嗰度見翻媽媽啦。咁最主要有兩樣嘢我哋想做嘅，第一就話翻俾佢聽我哋嗰個染色體嘅報告係正常嘅，另外就係想同佢 discuss 下呢一個whole exome sequencing 嘅，係啦。咁話喺嗰度啦，我哋當然就即係再去 assess 下佢嘅 medical 同 family history 啦。咁呢一個咧就係佢個pedigree 啦。咁呢度咧，呢、這個正方形咧就係我哋個 proband 啦，係啦，咁13日大。咁我頭先大概有講過啦，就係佢有個家姐嘅6歲，咁佢都係有眼距闊嗰個情況嘅。而媽媽咧都係有一啲 resembling 嘅 facial features 嘅，係啦。咁除咗嗰、那個眼距比較闊啦，咁佢自己都有即係 volunteer 就係話啊，我大概15、16歲嘅時候開始有啲啡色嘅頭髮出現啦，係啦。咁然之後亦都有一啲 right hearing。loss 啦，但佢就唔肯定系咪因为 infection 而影响到嘅。咁另外阿妈妈咧自己就有个妹，系啦，咁佢就有 heterochromia 噶，系啦，咁佢其中一只眼系蓝色嘅，系啦，咁亦都有facial features 啦，同埋 hair color change， 系啦。咁啊睇翻啊，咁你有冇其他嘅 family members 都有类似嘅情况啊？咁佢就 volunteer 咗一个 paternal side 嘅 family history 啊，佢嘅爸爸嘅兄弟姊妹入面呢有些小朋友呢都是的，例如这个31岁的女仔，她自己呢就两只眼都是蓝色 的，而她的 hearing impairment 呢就比较严重的，她是 require hand sign 去做 communication， 也都自己是读 special school 的，是的。另外呢就是这里有两个20几岁的男仔，咁佢哋咧都係個眼珠係唔同色，同埋都有 hair color change 嘅情況，係啦。咁喺呢個 family history 入邊咧，其實我哋就 suspect 緊一個 autosomal dominant form 嘅 Waldenburg syndrome 嘅。咁但係你見到啦，因為即係我哋點解 suspect autosomal dominant？ 因為我哋見到一個 vertical 嘅 transmission 啦，係啦。咁另外咧就係、是，但係咧見到好特別咧，就係呢一個 generation 咧其實係冇影響，即係佢幾個 siblings 都冇影響到嘅。咁所以咧，我哋就覺得可能係一啲 incomplete 嘅 penetrance 啦，同 expressivity 啦。咁你見到，因為就算我哋叫做 affected 嘅 individuals 啦，佢哋個 degree 都係有唔同嘅。有啲人可能要用 hand sign， 有啲個 hearing 直情冇影響添咁樣樣咯。咁呢個我哋 assess 完啦，咁我哋就即係講翻我哋即係臨床上我哋懷疑係呢個情況嘅，係啦。咁我哋亦都即係同佢講話，哦，我哋覺得即係 exome 會幫到你啦。咁喺呢一度，我哋即係喺個 counselling 入邊咧，主要咧就係解釋究竟 whole exome sequencing 係一啲乜嘢嚟噶啦。然之後一啲 possible outcomes 啦，即係我哋會唔會揾到嘢，揾唔到嘢 ，VUS incidental findings etc 嘅。係啦，咁亦都有講，除咗 Waldenburg syndrome 啦 ，imperfect anus 咧都係其中一個我哋有機會睇到啲嘢嘅一個 clinical indication 啦。咁另外亦都有 discuss， 即係同佢 discuss 關於一個 family 嘅 implication 嘅。咁你見到咧喺呢個 counseling session 入邊咧，都有好多 complex 嘅 information 要話俾佢聽，即係除咗我哋要同佢 clarify family history 啦，嗰個 genetic risk 啦，同埋即係我哋嗰啲 testing 咧，其實咧都需要即係比較長嘅時間去同佢 communicate 嘅，係啦。咁聽完我哋講咗咁多嘅嘢之後咧，媽媽就同我哋講，其實暫時我哋覺得唔需要咗個 testing 嘅，係啦。咁其實佢自己本身就話啊，即係可能都明白嘅，即係呢一樣嘢可能幫到，但係佢覺得要同屋企人商量，因為始終影響嘅咧唔係淨係佢自己或者而家呢個仔，係啦，咁反而咧就係佢譬如 paternal family 啦，咁同埋佢自己有一個妹噶嘛，係啦，而佢呢個妹咧，佢就話其實佢個妹咧就想生小朋友。 嘅，咁所以咧佢就覺得咧佢需要同佢個妹discuss 咗先，即係譬如話哦 ，in case 都係揾到啲咩，會唔會影響你嘅 pregnancy plan 啊咁樣？咁我哋咧係當然即係呢，因為呢一樣嘢我哋都知道，即係個 genetic testing 唔係淨係按個 medical 啦，就多少少係佢哋呢一個情況就係按個 family 啊。咁我哋就當然就明白佢，我哋就係、即係 offer 咗一個，即係我哋冇 force 佢去做呢個 test 啦，亦都 offer 咗一個 follow appointment 嘅。咁呢一度呢個 case 其實最主要咧就想即係帶出一樣嘢，就係 genetic counselling 咧係好需要 be non-judgmental 啦，亦都要 respect 個 patients 嘅 autonomy 嘅，係啦。然之後當然就 support 佢 decision 啦，即係佢哋覺得需要多啲時間去考慮，咁我哋就會即係 offer 呢一樣嘢，即係話啊，你可以去考慮嘅。咁如果你有 decision 就可以翻嚟，我哋就可以幫你安排個 testing 咁樣。咁其實咁啱咧，上個禮拜我哋就見翻呢個家庭啦，喺 OPD 嗰度，係啦。咁啊媽媽咧就話佢哋決定都係做嘅，係啦，因為佢覺得咧即係會幫到佢個仔啊。咁所以咧，我哋咧就幫佢安排咗個 testing 咁樣。咁、那個 result 咧而家就仲 pending 啦，咁樣嘅。咁然之後咧就去到第二個 case 啦。咁第二個 case 咧就係即系 endocrine team refer 過嚟啦，一個十歲嘅女仔嚟嘅。咁佢咧就係、是、其實喺七個月大左右咧就已經有 hyperkalemia 啦。咁佢個 presentation 咧就 loss of consciousness 啦。咁一直咧都即系 treated as 一個 renal tubular acidosis type 4咁樣樣嘅。咁 despite 佢有一個好好嘅 compliance 啦，同埋一個 low potassium diet 咧，佢都仲有一啲 recurrent episodes 嘅。咁 so far 嘅 investigation 咧都冇乜特別嘢揾到出嚟嘅。咁去到十歲嘅時候咧，即係 endocrinologist 做 re-evaluation 嘅時候咧，就發現佢嘅 aldosterone 同 adrenaline 啦都係 markedly elevated 嘅。咁所以咧就 raise 咗一個 clinical suspicion of 一個好長嘅名啦，就係、是、pseudo hypoaldosteronism 嘅 type 1A。係啦，咁佢做咗啲 biochemical testing 啦，同埋佢 clinical history 咧，即係 endocrinologist 咧都覺得係 compatible 嘅，係啦，就因為呢一個咁樣 clinical 嘅 suspicion 啦，咁佢嗰個drug 咧都即係有轉到咁樣嘅，係啦，咁因為即係呢一個係啦，咁然之後咧，我哋咧就做咗個 trio 嘅 whole exome sequencing 去睇下揾唔揾到個 genetic cause of 佢呢一啲 endocrine 嘅 issues 嘅。咁出到嚟咧，就係、是、一個 WNK 嘅基因改變嚟嘅，係啦，呢一個咧就係、是、可能呢一個就係可能即係 genetic 上面可能好似密碼，即係或者好難去理解嘅一樣嘢嚟嘅。咁其實咧就好簡單，其實通常咧我哋呢一個咧就係、是、一個 gene 嚟噶啦。咁然之後呢度咧係一個 version number， 咁因為一個 gene 咧就好長，有好多唔同嘅 parts 嘅。咁呢一個咧就講緊第七個 exon。係啦，咁因為我哋有 protein coding、non-protein coding 啦，咁 exon 咧就係 protein coding part， 咁佢一節一節嘅，咁佢就係第七節。咁 C 咧呢個咧就係 notes 即係 DNA 即係 coding DNA 嗰個 nomenclature 啦，咁就喺1685嗰個位，本身個 A 咧就變咗 G。咁 P 呢個咧就係關於按個 protein change 咁樣樣嘅。係啦，咁呢一個基因嘅改變咧，我哋就即係 classified as 一個 likely pathogenic 啦，就 based on 一個嗰、那個 ACMG 嘅 guideline。咁呢一個係一個 novel variant 嚟嘅，咁意思即係喺之前嘅 medical literature 咧係冇見過嘅。咁實我哋就見到咧因為我哋係做 trio 啦，即係有攞到 parents 嘅sample 啦，咁就發現呢一個嘅基因改變係嚟自 daddy 嘅。咁而呢一樣嘢咧，其實就呢、这、一個 WNK4 咧，其實咧就 associate with PHA 嘅 type 2B 啦，咁就唔係 1A 係 2B， 即係另外一個 subtype 嚟嘅。咁佢另外咧，即係另外一個名就叫 Gordon's syndrome 咁樣啦。咁雖然佢係一個從來未被人 report 過嘅一個 variant 咧，我哋都覺得佢 likely pathogenic 咧。其中一個原因就當然即係我哋有唔同嘅 classification 啦。另外一樣嘢就其他嘅 reported pathogenic mutation 咧，都係 cluster 呢個位嘅。係啦，咁呢一個係一個 overview of 成個 gene 啦，咁就第一個 exon 二三四五六七，去到第七個 exon， 你見到咧呢一啲我哋一啲 database 入邊揾到 pathogenic 同 likely pathogenic variants 咧，全部都 clustered 喺呢一度嘅。咁所以因為我哋揾到嗰個基因咧，都基因改變咧，都係喺呢一度，咁所以我哋覺得都大機會咧係導致到佢嗰個endocrine 嗰個情況嘅，係啦。 咁喺呢一度咧，我哋就即系讲翻少少啦。呢一个咧就喺 OMIM 嗰度攞出嚟嘅，咁 Type 2B 嗰啲 phenotypes 啦。咁另外一样嘢就系关于即系我哋觉得比较重要就系佢嗰个drug treatment 嗰度啊，佢就系 responsive to thiazide diuretics 嘅。係啦，咁我哋即係當然，我哋有呢一個 genetic results 嘅時候，當然我哋就會同翻我哋嘅同事去 discuss 翻啦。係啦，咁佢哋即係就覺得可能話哦，之前可能話 suspect type 1A 嗰啲 phenotype 咧，其實可能係由其他嘅情況影響咗嘅。係啦，咁所以其實佢哋都 agree 咧 type 2B 咧都係一個啱嘅 diagnosis 嚟嘅。係啦，咁呢一個 case 入邊咧，其實就見到咧有一個 medical implication 嘅，係啦，因為咧呢一個咁樣 type 2B subtypes 咧係 especially responsive to thiazide 嘅，咁所以咧我哋就將嗰個 proband 嘅藥咧就轉咗做 hydrochlorothiazide， 咁然之後咧就 result 成一個 well control 嘅 potassium 啦，係啦，咁然之後佢嘅 potassium 同埋 BP 咧之後咧都係正常嘅，係啦，咁去翻 family history 嗰度啦。係啦，咁就發現咧，其實爸爸咧曾經咧係有 renal stones 嘅，係啦，咁原來佢35歲嘅時候有 renal stones， 亦都做咗啲 blood 嘅 check up 咧，其實佢都曾經有 hyperkalemia 同埋 hypercalciuria 同埋 hypertension 嘅，係啦，咁但係咧佢一直都係 asymptomatic 嘅，係啦，咁另外咧啊佢嘅媽媽咧都係有類似嘅情況嘅，咁就係 adult onset 嘅，即係冇佢咁細個就 onset 啦，咁喺個 paternal family 入邊咧就仲有兩個阿姨。係啦，咁佢咧就即係冇即係 so far reported healthy。咁我哋見到呢一樣，因為啊小朋友有啦，爸爸有啦，咁我哋懷疑即係可能即係其實媽媽都有嘅，係啦。咁我哋咧就做咗一個 cascade 嘅 screening 啊。咁講緊咧嘅 cascade screening 就 include biochemical 嘅 screening 啦，同埋 genetic 嘅 screening。咁就發現咧，其實嗰個 genetics 咧出嚟就嫲嫲有啦，然之後呢個 paternal aunt 其實都係有嘅，係啦。咁爸爸呢一度當然即係我哋都再去幫佢做咗一啲新嘅 evaluation 啦。咁佢個 K 都係高嘅。咁雖然佢 asymptomatic 啦，但 ECG 其實已經有啲 hyperkalemic change 噶啦，係啦。咁所以咧，我哋咧就幫阿爸爸即係當然都係 start 個 treatment 啦。咁幾日之後佢嗰個 K 同 BP 咧就 normalize 咗啦。係啦，咁然之後個 paternal aunt 咧，佢咧其實 good past health 嘅，咁但係按個 screening 咧，其實佢都有 high serum K 同埋有個 high BP 嘅，咁所以即係所有 positive 嘅family members 咧，我哋都有去做一個 treatment 啦，咁而佢哋都係有個好嘅 response 嘅。咁所以喺呢個 case 入邊咧，我哋咧就想即係 illustrate 翻。幫到嘅事情啦，咁第一啦就係個 medical implication 就 end 咗個 diagnostic odyssey 啦，咁然之後另外一樣嘢我哋覺得好重要嘅咧，就係 enhance 咗嗰個 personalised treatment 同埋 precision medicine， 即係嗰個 drug treatment 嗰度咧就有一個即係一個 positive 嘅影響，揾到一個啱 efficient 嘅一個嘅藥啦。係啦，咁呢個 case 咧我哋都覺得即係 illustrate 到一個 multidisciplinary 嘅 management 嘅。咁 for 個 family 啦，咁除咗即係譬如我哋做 pediatrics 好多時候講緊個 family implication 咧，就係講緊啊會唔會影響嗰啲 siblings 啊或者其他即係再生小朋友個 recurrence risk 啊，咁喺呢個 case 入邊咧，除咗係呢一樣嘢咧，其實你見到個 screening 咧就 extend to 好多唔同嘅 family members 啊，咁可能其中一個比較叫做 drastic 少少嘅 implication 就係佢個 paternal aunt 啦，因為佢一直都唔會懷疑或者唔會去即係去 check up for 呢一樣嘢嘅，係啦。咁但係呢一個咁樣嘅 genetic testing 就 allow 咗其實佢自己即係都可以 enhance 到唔同 family members 嘅 medical care 嘅。然後咧就係第三個 case 啦。咁第三個 case 咧就係 neurologist refer 過嚟嘅一個8歲嘅仔仔啦，係啦。咁主要咧就 suspect 佢有啲 congenital myopathies 嘅。係啦，咁 core features 就 include delay walking 啦，咁而家佢 independent walker 嚟嘅，係啦，咁仲有 hypotonia 啊、hyporeflexia 啊等等嘅，係啦，咁之前嘅 investigation 就 include CK 啦，咁 CK normal 啦，咁 EMG 有啲 myopathic， 咁就冇做過 muscle biopsy 嘅，係啦，咁之前做過嘅 genetic testing 咧就包括 SMA， 咁 SMA 咧就 negative 嘅。 係啦，咁喺呢個 family history 入邊咧，就 reported to be no family history 啦，同埋 parents are non-consanguineous 嘅。咁你喺呢一個 pedigree 見到咧，就其實爸爸咧就同呢個家庭已經冇再 contact 噶啦。咁而我哋見到啊，冇一個 family history， 咁我哋不如先 offer 一個 singleton 嘅好 exam 啦。咁如果有啲咩，我哋就做 targeted sequencing in 個媽咪咁樣嘅。咁出到嚟咧 ，to our surprise 咧，就有一個 RYR1 嘅 variant。而呢一個咧係一個 well reported 嘅 likely pathogenic variant。咁點解我話咁 surprise 咧？就因為咧佢係嚟自呢一個 asymptomatic 嘅 mother 嘅。係啦，咁呢度有兩份 paper 啦，咁呢兩份 paper 咧各自咧都有 report 過同一個 mutation， 即係同一個 gene 同一個 mutation， 而係多過一個 patient 嘅，即係 total 應該係有大概四個 reported case 噶啦，係啦，咁而呢度咧，因為我哋做 exome 咧就淨係做咗個 proband， 咁所以咧呢一個 view 咧就係 for proband 嘅，咁你見到有一個 genetic change 就係喺呢一個位置啦。咁然之後，我哋做 Sanger sequencing 就發現，即係 proband 有嘅時候咧，媽媽咧都係有一個同一個基因嘅改變嘅，咁就係由 G 變咗做 A， 係啦。咁 RYR1 咧就係一個即係 well known 嘅 gene 咧，係導致唔同嘅neuromuscular disease， 係啦。咁你見到咧喺 OMIM 咧，佢有唔同嘅disease 啦。咁而咧個 inheritance 咧，既可以 AD 又可以 AR 嘅，係啦，尤其是就 central core disease， 佢雖然都係叫 central core disease， 但係個 inheritance 都係可以唔同嘅。咁所以咧，我哋即係當然就會 consult neurologist， 覺得即係睇下佢哋有啲咩意見啦，咁樣係啦。咁佢哋 clinically 其實佢都覺得似係 central core disease 㗎。咁我哋留翻即係我。unknown 嘅嘢咧，就係究竟佢呢一個係一個 autosomal dominant 嘅 inheritance， 定係一個 recessive 嘅 inheritance 咧？係啦，咁但係 by clinical 咧，其實咧就似 autosomal dominant 嘅 inheritance 嘅喎。咁但係個 puzzling 個位咧，就係話啊，點解媽媽會有咧？係啦，咁究竟係佢係 asymptomatic 啊，即係咪一個 reduced penetrance 嘅情況啊，定係佢係好 mildly affected 咧？咁我哋咧就做咗好 extensive 嘅 literature search， 我諗 so far 得一個人，即係成個 gene 入邊得一個 patient 係 report to mild phenotype 嘅啫。咁基本上 asymptomatic 咧，我哋係冇見過嘅。係啦，咁所以我哋都喺度諗，因為其實本身呢一樣嘢可以係 AR disease 嚟噶嘛，咁即係會唔會係其實個小朋友係一個 AR 嘅 inheritance 嚟嘅，即係一個 autosomal recessive inheritance， 但係咁啱即係可能 exome 我哋 detect 唔到第二個 variant 咧，係啦，咁究竟我哋係咪需要即係去做一啲 further testing 咧？係啦，因為即係例如會唔會其實佢有啲 gene 嘅duplicate 即係一啲copy number 的改變是 exome detect 得不太好的，那我們需要 proceed to other testing， 例如 MLPA 或者 RNA-seq 呢？但是個難度呢就是關於即是個爸爸那裡，因為我們沒有他的 contact 啦，所以即可能做個 analysis 那裡都會有一個難度的。Anyway， 那我們都先當然要見到病人啦，和去解釋我們找到的東西的，是啦。咁我哋即係佢即係入嚟嘅時候，我哋即係都有再問翻阿個 family history 嘅。咁媽媽咧就話啊，其實我冇乜嘢嘅，係啦，我係健康嘅咁。咁所以咧，我哋咧就準備咧，即係將呢個咁 complex 嘅 discussion 要話俾佢聽。即係我哋揾到個基因改變，但我哋又唔係好確定究竟嗰個遺傳模式啊各方面嘅事情嘅。係啦，咁我哋已經準備即係可能講關於即係 RYR1 相關嘅即係 management 啦，或者等等啦。咁亦都其實因為本身 RYR1 咧係一個有一個 known 嘅 drug response 嘅，係啦，咁就係同嗰啲麻醉藥有關嘅 complications 咁樣啦。咁我哋即係因為呢樣嘢都影響即係病人自己嘅 management 啦，我哋亦都即係 prepare 喺個 counselling 嘅時候講。咁當我哋話俾呢個病人知。即係話俾呢個家庭聽嘅時候咧，即係關於啊呢個基因改變其實係嚟自媽媽嘅時候咧，咁媽媽就話啊，其實咧我係真係有啲 muscle weakness 嘅，係啦，咁就係其實佢由好細個咧已經即係有呢一個 muscle weakness 嘅，即係例如佢即係行路啊各方面咧，表面上係冇乜嘢嘅，但係如果譬如話啊行樓梯，佢上幾層樓咧就會開始有一啲攰嘅情況出現嘅。咁佢一直咧都冇同任何醫生去講嘅，因為佢覺得成件事好 embarrassing 嘅，係啦。咁直至到因為佢知道呢一個 genetic change 係嚟自佢嘅時候咧，佢先講呢一樣嘢，係啦。咁當然，咁我哋就哦，咁呢一樣嘢就即係改變咗我哋個 counselling 啦， 係啦，即係雖然我哋 discuss 咗好耐，究竟話係 AD 啊 AR， 究竟會唔會需要其他 testing 咧？咁而家知道咗呢一個 family history 嘅，即係改咗，即係呢個 family history 有一個改變嘅時候咧，我哋都要 adapt 翻落個 genetic counselling 嗰度，因為譬如我頭先有講到啦，就係、是、關於嗰一個嘅藥物嗰一個影響啊。咁呢一樣嘢就唔單止個小朋友要留意啦，媽媽自己個本人嘅健康都係要留意嘅，係啦。咁就再即係同佢一路傾嘅時候咧，阿媽媽就突然間醒起，其實咧我都曾經有一啲嘅可能係有關係嘅喎。佢話佢 deliver 完阿女女嘅時候咧，就其實咧佢係發燒，然之後喺 ICU 留咗十日嘅，係啦。咁佢用係有用到麻醉藥嘅，咁所以我哋就覺得咧，其實佢嗰陣時 stay 咗喺 ICU 十日咧，個原因咧就係因為佢有呢個 gene 嘅 mutation 啦。咁然之後導致到佢一用呢一啲嘅麻醉藥嘅時候咧，就有一個 adverse 嘅 reaction 咁樣，係啦。咁喺呢個 case 嗰度咧，就想 illustrate 翻咧，即係其實 psychosocial issues 咧喺 genetic counselling 嘅 clinic 入邊咧係好常見嘅。咁所以即係 genetic counsellors 咧都要 clinically 要好 sensitive 去即係去處理呢一啲事情啦。咁喺呢一個 case 咧，我哋亦都希望即係即係帶到出嚟就係即係嗰個 scientific reasoning 啦，同埋一個 humanistic part of genetic counselling 咧，係有一個 interplay 同 interaction 嘅。咁最後啦，就嚟到第四個 case 啦。咁就一個我自己咧就好即係好印象深刻嘅一個 case 嚟嘅。係啦，咁咧就係、是、一個六歲嘅女女啦，咁就係喺 orthopedics 嗰度 refer 過嚟嘅，咁就 suspect 一個病叫 FOP， 咁呢個 FOP 咧嗰、那個全名咧就好長嘅，咁其實咧就主要咧個月個呢一個病名咧，佢想解釋嘅咧就係呢一啲病人咧會喺身體唔同嘅地方嗰度咧出現一啲新嘅骨頭，而呢一樣嘢咧係 progressive 嘅。係啦，咁你見到呢個圖咁樣呢個卡通，正常人嘅骨係咁樣啦，有 FOP 嘅病人咧，佢哋嘅骨絡係生成咁樣嘅。咁呢一樣嘢唔係一出世就係咁樣嘅，係咧一路大大下咧就會，咦點解個背脊有啲一粒粒嘅嘢嘅咁樣？咁然之後即係突起咁樣，但係又未必好痛嘅，係啦。咁如果佢照一個 X 光咧，你就會見到佢啲骨咧係咁樣嘅。係啦，咁就唔係淨係背脊嘅，喺身體各個地方咧都可以生一啲 extra 嘅骨頭嘅，例如手臂啊、關節位啊都係嘅。咁呢一樣嘢最令人困擾嘅咧，就係即係如果譬如佢嗰個新生嘅骨頭生喺一啲關節位嘅時候咧，就會影響佢嗰個關節嘅喐動嘅。咁所以咧都係一個即係會影響一個 mobility 嘅一個情況咁樣樣啦。咁唯獨是有一啲嘢係一出世就會見到嘅咧，就係呢啲人士通常咧佢個腳趾弓咧有個 malformation 嘅。咁但係一出世嘅時候，除咗呢一樣嘢咧，都唔會見到嘅。咁所以咧呢一啲小朋友通常個 diagnosis 咧都係去到佢真係有新生嘅骨頭嘅時候，先會發現嘅。但係呢一個咧係一個好罕見嘅疾病啦，即係講緊係100万至200万人咧先有一個嘅，係啦。咁、那個 genetic etiology 咧就已經知道㗎啦，咁係一個 gene 叫 ACVR1 嘅一個 mutation 嚟嘅，係啦。咁係一個 hotspot variant， 即係大部分嘅 case 咧都係同一個 genetic change 咧就會即係會導致呢一個情況咁樣啦。咁 upon referral 嚟我哋嗰度嘅時候咧，我哋即係未同佢做 genetic testing 咧，咁其實個家庭咧已經咧好有 stress， 即係好 stressful 啦。因為咧，其實佢哋咧有聽完呢個 diagnosis 之後，即係呢個 suspicion 嘅時候咧，其實佢哋自己已經 Google 咗好多嘢。咁喺 Google 咧，其實你 search 呢個病嘅時候咧，就會有好多唔同嘅相片啊等等咧走咗出嚟嘅。咁而即係我哋第一次見呢個家庭嘅時候咧，爸爸已經講啦，話啊成日咧都即係心跳加速啊，又血壓又唔係幾好，媽媽啊成日見暈，又食唔到嘢，瞓即係又瞓唔到覺咁樣樣，係啦，已經去到一個咁樣嘅情況咁樣樣啦。咁喺個 clinic 度，媽媽咧即係都有去，即係佢都即係喊曬啊咁樣樣嘅。咁佢係好唔想去即係接受呢一個 diagnosis 啦，即係雖然我哋未做過 testing， 佢都有問啊，會唔會做出嚟你個 test 唔啱㗎？會唔會係錯㗎？會唔會唔係呢個病㗎？咁樣樣啦。 咁我哋喺個 clinic 度都要即係當然就安慰佢啦。咁因為嗰日小朋友都有嚟到嘅，咁嫲嫲就帶咗佢出去咁樣樣。咁我哋即係我哋當然就要即係叫繼續去幫佢咁樣啦。咁我哋嗰日咧亦都有將佢 refer 去 clean 曬嗰度嘅。咁出嚟啦，就即係個 confirm 咗呢一個 genetic 嘅 diagnosis 啦。咁我哋呢個 resource disclosure 咧，最尾咧就係喺個 multidisciplinary clinic 嗰度做嘅。咁呢個 multidisciplinary clinic 咧就有我哋 orthopedics 嘅同事啦、endocrine 嘅同事啦，同埋我哋 genetics 嘅同事嘅，係啦。咁我哋希望即係呢一個咁樣嘅 multidiscipline 嘅即係 arrangement 咧，可以幫到佢哋多啲嘅。係啦，咁我哋喺個 clinic 度個 genetic counselling 當然就係 explain 個 diagnosis 啦 ，natural history。咁但係其實咧，除咗即係 explain 呢一樣嘢之外咧，就係個 management approach 啦。係啦，因為咧其實有一啲 prophylactic 嘅藥咧係可以去食，然之後咧去即係令到成件事即係可以 prevent 到一啲 flare ups 嘅。係啦，咁亦都有唔同嘅 guidelines 啦。係啦，咁呢度即係我哋就希望一個 multidisciplinary 嘅。approach 是可以幫到他的，係啦。咁亦都有幾隻 drugs 咧，其實喺個 clinical trial 度係 under 緊，即係 under clinical trial， 佢希望可以 slow down 個 progression 咁樣樣，係啦。咁其實呢一度呢一份嘢咧，就係一個 international， 即係喺佢嗰個 society 入邊嘅一個 FAQ 咁樣樣。咁我哋咧就即係而家即係就有即係 translate 咗去做中文嘅，係啦。咁而下面呢一個相咧，就係即係嗰位小朋友嗰日喺個 clinic， 我哋即係同父母傾緊嘅時候，佢畫嘅相片咁樣樣啦，即係畫嘅圖啊咁樣。咁你見到即係我哋有阿童醫生喺度啦，因為佢嗰日有 clinic 啦，又畫咗另外一個盧醫生啦，咁同埋就係爹哋媽咪。咁呢個就係佢畫翻佢自己出嚟咁樣樣嘅。係啦，咁呢度咧，其實我都想帶出一樣嘢咧，就係喺 genetics 入邊咧，其實 in multidisciplinary 嘅team 咧係好重要嘅，係啦。咁即係除咗即係頭先我有講到啦，咁呢頭先我哋就係 occur 喺呢一個嘅combined clinic 啦，係啦。咁即係除咗我哋有orthopedics 嘅同事啦 ，endocrine 嘅同事啦，咁同埋我哋有時喺兒童醫院咧，亦都會有 radiologist 啦，同埋 dentist 去 join 呢一啲嘅 clinic 嘅。咁而喺呢度我哋就主要處理一啲例如 skeletal dysplasia。嘅一啲 patients 啦，咁我哋希望一個咁樣嘅 approach 咧，就可以幫到佢哋，咁佢哋唔使分可能好多次嚟我哋呢一度去做一個見醫生嘅，咁我哋希望喺一個 clinic 度咧就可以處理佢各方面嘅問題啦。咁除咗multidisciplinary team 咧，我哋都仲有其他嘅 joint clinic 嘅。咁例如我哋亦都有同 cardiologist 一齊去做一個 joint clinic 啦，咁主要處理一啲long QT 嘅情況，即係 arrhythmia 啦，咁亦都有cardiomyopathy 嘅 patients 嘅，係啦。咁另外啦，我哋喺贊育醫院咧，亦都有即係同obstetricians 佢哋一齊咧去睇一個prenatal diagnostic clinic 嘅，係啦。咁之前啦，即係喺 COVID 之前，我哋曾經咧即係都有一啲 multi D 嘅 meeting 啦，咁就係同我哋 neurologist 啊，同埋唔同嘅同事啦，我哋即係 DH 嘅 geneticist 啊，同然之後pathology 嘅同事啊咁樣嘅。咁我哋覺得咧，即係喺一個 genetics 或者 genomics 嘅 era 入邊咧，其實一個 multidisciplinary approach 係好重要嘅。係啦，咁去到最尾啦，咁就係關於個 take home message 啦。咁其實希望咧就係喺之前嗰幾個 case 嗰度咧，就 illustrate 到其實 genetic counselling 咧係一個 process 嚟嘅。係啦，咁而家我哋有唔同嘅 advancement 啦，係啦，咁所以咧其實 genetic counselling 嗰一個嘅嗰個 practice 咧都一直改變緊嘅。係啦，咁而家有好多 testing 咧，就其實只要抽一支血做一個 test 咧，已經可以即係 bring 到唔同嘅 results 出嚟啦。咁而個 communication 咧就變到 more complex 嘅，係啦。咁而即係需要討論嘅嘢亦都越嚟越 extensive 啦。咁所以咧，我哋咧都覺得即係一個 multidisciplinary 嘅 approach 咧係好 beneficial to 個 patient care and management 嘅，係啦。咁回應翻個 topic 啦 ，making sense of the genetic results 咧，其實想帶出嘅咧就唔係淨係 make sense of 個 genetic report， 而係關於成個 process 啊，即係關於即係嗰個 patient 有呢個 diagnosis， 然之後佢嘅 management 啦，係啦，咁即係關於佢自己個人嘅健康啦，佢嘅家庭要承受的啦，同埋即係佢哋去到即係社會嗰一方面，咁呢一樣嘢我哋即係覺得喺 genetic counseling 入邊咧，都係一個即係好重要嘅環節嚟嘅。咁樣樣嘢咧都係緊緊即係環環相扣咁樣樣啦。咁最尾啦，可能容許我賣少少廣告啦，就係、是、關於我哋 Hong Kong Genome Institute 嘅，係啦。咁而因為我哋見到即係 genomics 即係 medicine 咧，其實咧已經即係發展得越嚟越越嚟越。多啦，咁喺2017年嘅時候咧，就有四大個嘅 international 即係一啲嘅projects 咁樣啦。咁例如 UK 佢 launch 咗佢嘅 100K 嘅 genome project 啦，然之後喺美國又有 All of Us 咁樣去 involve 咗1 million people 係啦。咁去到而家，咁其實咧100K Genome Project 咧就已經完成咗啦，咁亦都埋緊尾噶啦，係啦，咁去到呢一份咧應該係2020年嘅，咁你見到咧佢已經即係 genomics into healthcare 呢樣嘢已經變咗 global responsibilities 啦，就由即係頭先嗰四個國家2年嘅時間咧已經變到即係世界各地都有唔同嘅 initiative 整緊嘅。係啦，咁你見到即係即係歐洲啊、亞洲、美洲咧，其實都有已經做緊唔同嘅嘢啦。咁呢度亦都 summarize 咗，就呢份 paper 應該係啱啱年頭出嘅，係啦。咁你見到咧 ，internationally 咧都做咗，做咗唔同嘅projects 啦。咁 involve 嘅人咧都越嚟越多。咁有啲咧就做 rare disease， 有啲咧就做一我哋叫做 common 少少嘅 disease 咁樣樣嘅。係啦，咁如果講翻即係香港啦，咁香港咧喺2017年嘅時候咧 ，Food and Health Bureau 咧亦都即係 set up 咗呢一個 steering committee 去 develop genomic medicine in Hong Kong 嘅，係啦。咁最主要咧，佢想 address 四大個 issues 啦。第一就係 standardize 翻香港 genomic medicine 嘅 clinical service 啦。咁當然啦，就要 supported by 一啲 laboratory service 啦。咁亦都要 translate 呢啲 laboratory service into clinical use。咁另外啦，就希望即係有好多即係會可以有多啲嘅 healthcare professionals 去 specialize in genomic medicine 啦。咁然之後就係關於市民嗰度就有一即係同埋 enhance 翻即係 healthcare workers 嘅 genomic literacy。咁另外咧就係關於即係 genomic medicine 帶嚟嘅ethical legal 同埋 social implications 都係咧我哋即係呢個strategic planning 嗰度想帶出嘅嘢。咁 based on 呢樣嘢咧，其實喺呢一個 committee 咧就advise 咗8個 recommendations 嘅，係啦。咁有好去 address 翻頭先嗰四樣嘢啦。咁其中一樣嘢咧比較即係我哋launch 緊咧，就係關於呢個 Hong Kong Genome Institute 啦。咁 set up 呢個 Hong Kong Genome Institute 咧，咁其實最主要咧就係想 launch 一個 Hong Kong Genome Project 咁樣啦。咁希望咧我哋喺呢一個 institute 入邊 launch 咗呢個 project 咧，就可以 enhance 個 clinical application 嘅。係啦，咁一嚟除咗 enhance 個 clinical application of 呢個 genomic medicine 之外咧，第二樣嘢咧就係一個 promote research 嘅，係啦，然之後去 facilitate 之後嘅 medical development， 係啦，咁 throughout 呢個 project 咧，希望咧可以establish 到一個 local 嘅 database 啦，一個 infrastructure for genetic and genomic testing 啦，同埋一個 talent pool for genomic medicine 嘅。咁呢個 project 咧，主要咧就分成兩個 phase， 係啦。咁 total 我哋 expect 咧就會做到40,000至50,000個 genome 嘅。咁第一個 phase 咧就大概做2000個 case 咁樣，然之後咧就去 main phase 嗰度就做埋個 remaining 嘅。咁我哋除咗即係喺 HKGI 入邊之外咧，我哋就會同唔同嘅 organisation 即係去合作啦。咁我哋有三大個 partnering centres 嘅，咁包括兒童醫院啦、威爾斯啦同埋瑪麗醫院嘅。咁亦都會同兩間大學合作，即係香港大學、中文大學合作咧，去做呢一個 genome project 嘅。係啦，咁喺呢度我就想多謝 Dr. Brian Zhong 啦。咁因為呢啲所有嘅事情，即係都係由佢即係教導我咁樣，我先即係識呢啲嘅 genetic counselling 嘅嘢嚟嘅。咁亦都好多謝即係喺 Hong Kong U 嘅 genetics team 啦，同埋唔同嘅同事啦。咁喺 Hong Kong U 喺兒童醫院喺 QM 嘅同事都想多謝佢哋嘅。係 ，thank you。
好，多謝曬啊 Jasmine。咁大家希望都即係有一個幾 interesting 嘅一個鐘咁樣啦。咁你哋如果睇到即係 Jasmine 嗰幾個 case illustration 咧，都睇到大概一個 genetic counselor 要有啲咩 skills 嘅。第一個就是 communication skills， 咁 Jasmine 就 demonstrate 咗兩方面。第一方面咧就係佢同啲唔同嘅家長啦，小朋友啦嘅 interaction 做得好好啦。大家有冇留意到嗰幅畫係冇我嘅，得佢嘅啫，原來都唔記得咗我噶啦嚇，因為咁有啲相冇我就因為我係揸機嗰個啫。但係嗰幅咧，即係小朋友嘅心目中咧，呢、這個姐姐最幫到佢手，即係喺個診斷啊或者點樣哦，見到佢安慰佢個爸爸媽媽，甚至同佢自己解釋翻嗰個 result。咁第二樣 communication skills 當然就好似Jasmine 剛才 communicate 到了一個這麼 complicated 的 topic， 她都可以呢、就是、用一個相對簡單的方法來去講給大家聽。第二件事呢就是個 genetics 和 genomics 的 knowledge， 大家都見到呢其實 Jasmine 呢、就是、在整件事的分析那裡呢做得很好。那為什麼呢？因為 Jasmine 她自己 train 的時候，她不單止跟我們去 clinic， 她跟我們做一些基因的 analysis。 那以我嚟講，我認識外國好多 genetic counselor， 佢哋都未必識得做 genomic 嘅 analysis。Jasmine 就 take 咗自己啲時間去做，咁大家見到嗰個時間係 well spent 嘅，因為咧就會令到佢對於啲事情睇得好透徹。咁第三樣嘢好重要咧 ，Jasmine 都 demonstrate 到咧，就係佢要有一個 continuous interest。佢見你哋可以見得到佢，即係佢而家啲 knowledge 咧，可能都已經即係喺某一啲嘅 rare disease。媲美到一啲即係醫護人員咧，做得好好。咁佢亦都要對updated 嘅 research 好了解啦。例如佢要知道有啲 clinical trial 可能 benefits 到啲 patient 啊咁樣啦。嚇、啊、咁所以我估咧，即係點解我會講得咁詳細咧？就是、因為有其中一條問題咧，就係、是、問 how to become a genetic counselor。咁我諗有兩個即係情況可以答你嘅，就係即係喺operational 點樣可以做啦？我知道即係而家醫管局就 actively 咁 explore 緊呢一件事啦，嚇、啊、咁所以可能喺個即係個 creation 嗰度發生咗咧，啲嘢就 backward 咁樣去做翻，就可以去睇下究竟我哋要設計啲咩 training course 先至可以製造到一啲好似 Jasmine 咁樣可以 contribute 到喺 genomic medicine。咁但係個 mindset 我覺得好緊要啦。咁 Jasmine 頭先嗰個就係一個幾好嘅 demonstration on 嗰個 mindset。咁或者我等睇下 Jasmine 會唔會想講兩句 how to become a genetic counselor， 會唔會有少少嘢想講翻？
好啊，咁thank you 啦。咁啊，即係如果話要去做 genetic counselors 方面咧，其實就有即係唔同嘅途徑嘅。咁係譬如話喺香港嚟講咧，而家其實都有少少即係 postgraduate 嘅 training 咧，係即係同呢一方面係有關係嘅，係啦。咁但係即係話喺個職位上啊，各方面咧，而家咧其實真係好 actively， 我哋去 establish 緊，我哋亦都好希望咧，即係之後可以有一啲即係 standard 啊，或者即係一啲operational， 我哋可以做到一啲嘢，可以 ensure 到做一個 standardized 嘅 training。因為譬如喺外國咁樣啦，佢哋就有一啲 master program 啊，去即係去做一個 master of genetic counselling， 亦都咧有一啲嘅organization 咧係會 certify 一啲 genetic counsellors 嘅。係啦，咁香港咧暫時就未有呢一方面嘅即係certification 啊嗰啲嘅，係啦。咁但係我哋就希望即係因為即係 genetic counselling 佢嗰個範疇都好廣闊啦。咁我哋希望即係如果即係有興趣嘅各位人士咧，即係其實都有一啲我哋希望可以 establish 咗啲嘢。咁例如 nurses 咧，其實都係會我哋覺得係。即是一個很好的人士是可以去做到 genetic counselling 的，是的。
好啊，好。另外一條問題呢，我見到呢是一個呢起碼有20行的一個 case 來的，就是可能想我們即給一點意見的，那我們抄回回去慢慢看完再回答回。那還有另外一條問題呢，挺有趣的，挺學術性的，就是問了sexual orientation究竟可唔可以用 genetics 嚟到去 predict？ Jasmine 有冇咩睇法啊
？Sexual orientation 嗰度咧，
我哋應該 clinic 冇睇過。
我哋 clinic 就冇睇過。係啊，咁如果即係我諗我哋就少啲，係咪？
我諗我哋 clinical 就少啲，咁所以如果用翻。即係一個大方向嗰個答法，我哋都可以睇翻即係呢一樣嘢，究竟我哋覺得係一啲 multifactorial in 即係個 pathogenesis 或者 in 個 origins 啊，定係 likely 係一啲 single gene disease 嚟啦。咁如果以我睇 sexual orientation 呢樣嘢咁複雜，多數都係 multifactorial 嘅。咁所以咧，而家即係如果我哋講係比較針對性一個 single gene 咁樣嘅 approach， 未必啱用。咁所以可能係要用啲 complex phenotype 嗰個 approach。咁如果以喺外國而家喺啲 conferences 嗰度討論咧，都有幾個層面嘅，好似頭先阿 Jasmine 講，喺 ethics、legal、喺 discrimination 嗰個層面，即究竟呢一個咁樣嘅 research topic，我哋要注意啲乜嘢咧 ？Scientific value 應該係有嘅，好多人都會有 interest in 佢呢一樣咁樣嘢，但係喺個 social context、societal context， 我哋都要好小心嚇，因為我哋而家講緊好多唔同嘅範疇，我哋都係希望唔好用咗一啲未成熟嘅 scientific fact 去令到有啲 discrimination 出現。咁所以喺各國有呢啲咁樣嘅 project 咧，個第一步反而咧就用幾多時間嘅，就係個 ethics committee 嘅 approval。咁啱啱即係我哋兒童醫院 child sim talk 呢度又有一個 series 講好多關於呢方面嘅嘢啦。咁另外一方面咧，如果由個 research 嗰個角度嚟到去睇咧，反而個 genomic sequencing 而家似乎唔係一個問題，因為我哋已經好多地方都已經做到個 whole genome sequencing， 反而就係個 phenotyping， 即係。究竟 sexual orientation 呢一樣嘢係咪一種 phenotype 嚟嘅咧？定係有唔同嘅 phenotype？ 我哋方便起見，將佢 group 咗做一件事，叫做 sexual orientation。男仔同女仔嘅 sexual orientation 嗰個即係形成喺即係biology 上又有冇分別嘅咧？嚇咁另外你點樣去做呢一個 study？ 點樣去 clinically assign 一個人 into 個 case group 或者個 control group？ 呢啲都係好多同事係 internationally 有做過呢方面嘅經驗，我哋兩個就冇啦。會discuss 或者會講翻俾我哋聽個 challenge 喺邊度。咁我諗我哋要 stay tuned， 暫時就唔係有好多嘅資料去講呢一樣咁嘅嘢。咁或者我睇下啲時間，好似都已經我哋又超時啦，唔好意思，多Chan，我哋次次都超時。好啊，好啊。咁多Chan就想我哋睇埋，就係genetic counselor 係咪 covered by medical insurance 喎？
係，因為咧 genetic counselor 咧暫時喺香港咧都唔係一個 well established 嘅即係 occupation 嚟嘅。咁所以關於個 medical insurance 嗰度咧，就即係可能就暫時就未有嘅。係啦，因為譬如我之前咧就即係主要跟多去衝咧，其實我個 employment 咧就係擺 Hong Kong U 嘅，係啦，咁所以咧就有少少唔同啦，係啦，咁如果你話外國嘅話咧，其實佢哋就應該會有啦，咁我希望之後個 development 咧亦都會做到，因為始終即係 genetic counselors 咧都好多即係 work 係其實係喺個 clinic 啊，或者即係唔同嘅clinical 嘅地方啊咁樣樣嘅，係啦。
好，咁多謝 Jasmine。咁仲有一條啊 ，Doctor Chan 都想我哋答翻嘅，就係話哦，而家咧有衞生署遺傳科啊，我哋啲好朋友 Doctor Ivan Low 啊 ，Doctor Luke 就喺嗰度啦。啊，咁亦都有 Hong Kong Genome Institute 喎。咁我哋點樣去 refer 啊？係 refer 俾你啊，定係 Clinical Genetic Service 咧？個答案一定係㗎啦，梗係俾阿大佬嘅 Doctor Ivan Low 佢哋嘅嚇。咁啊Department of Health 就係一路歷史悠久咧，即係喺 run 緊即係 territory right 嘅 clinical genetic service 嘅。如果以 service 嚟到去計咧，我知道即係 Hong Kong U 同 CU 啊，遲少少即係呢度喺兒童醫院，我哋都會有多少少嘅 service 嚟嘅。咁Hong Kong Genome Institute 咧就唔係一間醫院嚟嘅。係一個 research institute 嚟嘅，不過咧佢嘅其中一個工作就要去做好嗰個 Hong Kong Genome Project， 咁呢個係一個合作嚟嘅，咁所以咧Hong Kong Genome Project 咧裏邊除咗即係包括喺嗰間 institute 入邊嘅同事，亦都包埋咗醫管局啊、衛生署啊同埋兩間大學嘅同事嚟嘅，我哋會一氣過睇呢一樣嘢。咁好似阿 Jasmine 頭先講，我哋最初咧就會係即係 focus 多少少喺 undiagnosed disease 同 hereditary cancer 啊，咁唔可能一下就去咗我哋嗰度，因為 undiagnosed 嘛，佢哋一定要經過個過程，即係已經係睇過啲醫生，已經有相當嘅 diagnostic 嘅程序做咗，咁啲醫生覺得哦可能。同 genetics 有關，可能 genome sequencing 幫到嗰個病人，咁所以我哋會一氣過咁樣去處理呢個問題嘅。咁容許我哋用一個官僚少少嘅方法，不日會有詳情公佈，多謝大家留意。
一個問題想有兩個問題想問。嗱，第一個問題就係、是、啊，你而家知道即係香港啲人對啲私隱又好緊張啦。頭先阿 Jasmine 就講話啊，我哋會收啲市民啊，或者香港啲人嘅 genome 嘅 data 咁樣。咁你擔唔擔心啲人其實即係好抗拒呢樣嘢啊？即係安心出行都唔制啦，啲人咁你 genome 咁你。他們有沒有這個 concern 呢？我們怎樣 address 這個 concern 呢？其實
大部分不同的國家，如果他是要去做一個比較大規模的 genome project 呢，第一件事處理就是Dr. Chan 剛才提出的事情，那個是很需要即大家明白這件事的目的是做些什麼的。那大家明白了個目的之後呢，就容易去開始談了。咁點解要做一個咁大規模嘅 genomic project 咧？其實有幾個目的嘅。第一就係希望揾出嚟嘅嘢，好似頭先嗰四個 case 咁，直接可以幫到病人，係真係想幫人。咁但係咧，我哋嘅能力去幫到嘅病人咧，除咗靠我哋讀多啲書，政府俾多啲資源咧，數據庫都好重要。大家都知道啦，唔同嘅人種係有分別嘅，唔同國家嘅人種個分別都可以好大。咁因為唔同嘅原因啦，其實而家遺傳基因裏面嘅數據庫咧，大部分八成以上都係西方人、白種人嘅。咁我哋其中一個好重要嘅步驟咧，就係、是、如果揾到個基因改變，究竟佢係咪喺健康嘅人都已經揾到，定係係一個唔常見嘅改變 ，and therefore 高啲機會率同疾病有關。但係而家我哋查啲嘢，如果喺個數據庫裏邊揾唔到咧，除咗係頭先我講嘅第一個 conclusion， 真係喺健康嘅人口裏邊揾唔到，仲有一個隱憂，會唔會其實只係嗰個改變喺白人裏邊少見，但喺中國人裏邊好多嚇？咁我哋可唔可以借助其他中國人嘅數據庫啊？都得嚇。不過我哋都知道嚇，就算喺中國入邊一個咁大嘅地方，可能都有啲分別。咁如果我哋喺呢度睇我哋嗰啲病人，我哋喺呢度儲緊嗰啲數據，應該係最直接，即係幫到手我哋去做呢件事。咁所以其中一個過程咧，就係我哋要令到啲市民明白我哋做緊啲乜嘢嘢。啊，咁明白我哋做緊啲咩都唔夠嘅喎，我哋仲要設計到一套保護，即係嗰啲 data 嗰個私隱度嘅一個整套嘅一套方針。咁呢兩樣嘢夾埋。我哋咧就希望咧就俾到啲市民信心嚇。咁如果以外國嘅經驗咧，外國嘅經驗就係、是、除咗講呢兩樣嘢，你都仲要話俾佢聽係有個機會係啲資料會外泄嘅，但係個資料係好細。咁但係資料外泄，我哋又驚啲乜嘢嘢咧？可能咧就係驚有人會利用呢啲嘢對我哋有害嚇。咁所以頭先可能我哋冇 touch on 好多，但係個 recommendation 都有講，譬如會唔會？導致到有 discrimination 噶，會唔會我翻工因為我有呢個報告揾唔到份工？會唔會我想去買醫療保險買唔到？咁呢個亦都係整個 strategic development 裏邊其中一啲 recommendations， 而家已經開始處理緊。咁所以我哋係有用嘅，我哋唔係攞啲資料嚟玩嘅，係真係有作用，幫到我哋醫生。我哋會盡力保護啲資料，當然冇嘢係 zero risk。Foolproof 嘅，但系如果泄咗啲資料出嚟，我哋係有法例保障，係希望將嗰個 damage 令到市民嗰個 damage 減到最低。呢、這個似乎係雖然冇一本書咁樣寫，但係國際嘅 genomic project 個共識嚟。咁所以呢件事點解唔係話我今日我哋三月翻工啊？唔係話三月翻工，三月就可以開始，就係因為有好多呢啲咁樣嘅功夫，我哋唔敢咁快即刻開展。反而啲準備功夫十分之重要。
咁啊 ，Jasmine， 其實我跟住問嗰個問題，同頭先都有啲關係，就係、是、嗰個 incidental finding。
嗯。
咁頭先你講啦，就做之前都要 counsel 一輪啦。係。即係我仲記得有一隻歌啊，Rosemary Cooney 叫做咩 ？And I really don't want to know 啊。
嗯。
即係你唔好話俾我聽。
嗯。
咁係啦，佢係唔想你話俾佢聽啦，嗰刻唔想話俾佢聽。但你真的做到一些 data 出来呢、啊、譬如 Bracket Gene 樣真的影響他健康的，又有得 intervention 是有用的。又、或者剛才 Brian 這樣說，我找了你的數據出来，但是 當時是沒有事的，但可能過得一兩年，咦不是喔，即是這一堆人他們這個 characteristic 是有影響他的身體健康的，那我們怎樣處理呢？
嗯，好，因為其實有一個關於 incidental finding 那裡呢都有一些 guidelines 的，即譬如即 ACMG 那裡呢就 recommend 暫時是59個基因，而這59個基因已經即經過專家的商討啦，就覺得即報了出來呢是可以有 actionability 的，即有 clinical use 他們呢才會去報的，係啦，咁就唔係話其他咁樣嘅，即係其他唔同嘅基因都會報嘅，係即係佢哋有即係有一個 list 去即係去篩選邊一啲去報，邊啲唔報。咁當然啦 ，BRCA 係其中一個會報嘅，因為已經知道佢有嘢可以做，即係有啲 prevention 嘅 methods 啊，或者即係 clinically 有嘢可以做到啦。係啦，咁如果即係譬如話佢 consent 嘅時候，因為其實我哋咧，除即係 consent 咧，就 consent 你知唔知道呢一個 incidental finding， 就係講緊嗰一刻嗰個 analysis 嘅。咁另外有一啲情況，即係而家都有去討論咧，就係、是、個 consent for recontacting 係啦。咁就係話啊，即係因為即係 genetic medicine 啊 ，genomic medicine 呢啲嘢一直都即係發展緊啦。咁可能遲啲嗰個59個 gene list 咧，可能變咗100個咁樣嘅，係啦。咁亦都有呢一個嘅可能性嘅。咁所以有陣時有啲 discussion 就按你會唔會想我哋 recontact 你係啦。咁 in case 啊有啲咩嘅時候，我哋 recontact 你，而之後譬如我哋可能話俾你聽啊，我哋有一啲 additional 嘅嘢想話翻俾你知喎。咁到時你就再選擇嚟唔嚟去即係。聽過那個 counselling 咁樣樣咯，
係啦。係咪即係如果佢話咗我唔想聽，就算嗰59個 gene
係啦，我哋
你
都
唔會話俾佢聽嘅，
唔會嘅，係啦。
係
咁，所以正genetic counselling 重要咧，就係佢係一個 process 嚟嘅、，establish 嗰個 relationship 又好緊要。我哋唔係靠嗰張紙嘅，因為我哋知道病人會改變主意嘅。佢、有時簽咗紙話知。講咗俾佢聽之後咧，亦都有試過，我好後悔，我簽咗。咁跟住再喺覆診嘅時候，我又好想多謝翻你嘅，因為我後悔完一輪咧，我就的起心肝去做 body check。啊，原來發覺我係一個好 early stage 啊，嗰個手術好簡單噶 ，day surgery 嚟嘅啫 ，Doctor Zhong 做完啦，而家我好翻啦，全靠你話翻俾我哋聽。呢個係一個真實嘅個案，咁所以我哋要明白，即係整件事同人嗰個 psychology 係好有關係。人嘅 psychology 心理狀況就係會變，咁所以我哋個 practice 咧又唔係靠嗰一張紙 consent， 好似上個禮拜嗰個討論一樣，係一個 dynamic process 嚟嘅。我哋 expect 啲人會轉添，咁就住佢轉嘅時候，我哋就睇下有啲乜嘢對於佢最有利。咁當然啦，對於一個人最有利嘅嘢，要嗰個人自己諗先至知道。不過我哋因為明白呢、這、一個即係呢個 process 係咁，所以成件事係 flexible。咁所以個 consenting 而家好多人都講係 dynamic 嘅。咁除咗頭先阿陳醫生講嗰個 situation， 我哋兒科可能會 deal with 一樣嘢，就係18歲之前爸爸媽媽同你決定，18歲之後佢自己有唔同嘅諗法。呢、這個我哋都係尊重嘅。行規都已經是尊重。咁如果講翻我哋而家開展或者開始去籌備嘅 Hong Kong Genome Project 咧，裏邊亦都會有一啲關節位咧，其實係要處理到呢啲嘢。我哋要諗好咗先開始，因為非常之 likely 喺個50,000個 genome 20,000+ 個案裏面咧，梗有啲唔同嘅 situation 我哋要 handle。諗唔曬，咁所以點解我哋需要有咁多 partnerships， 有唔同嘅專家，可能嗰個累積嘅經驗咧，可以幫到我哋即係比較圓滿咁處理呢啲不同好 challenging 嘅個案。所以而家其實我哋唔係覺得嗰個 sequencing challenge， 係個 analysis challenge， 係點樣用到嗰個 result 去幫到人，唔會令到啲人有 psychological stress， 而幫到人同 psychological stress 係 dynamic 嘅會變。嗰度先至係 challenging 啊！咁嗰個應該對於我哋嚟講咧，喺呢個階段裏邊，喺做完呢個 genome project 裏邊咧，我哋會學到嘢，或者可能喺完咗個 project， 喺個 project 中段咧，我哋有多啲個案係可以分享到嘅。
不過我估真係大家真係要 stay tuned。頭先嗰句説話真係要 stay tuned， 因為我諗件事都會發展得好快，真係越嚟越平啊！我哋見到啲病人喺國內做完一大堆嘢，拎翻俾我哋就知道。咁所以我諗大家唔好當呢個係將來嘅嘢啦，呢個係現在嘅嘢。咁真係要 embrace 佢啦。醫護人員要 embrace 啦，我諗個 public 都要 embrace。 咁問啲啱嘅問題啦，作啲啱嘅 decision 啦。冇一樣嘢真係話，好似話齋，唔係話我哋講得啱，係你自己講啱，係唔同嘅人生階段有唔同嘅 decision 都唔定。咁大家翻去諗下就會明噶啦，即係有啲嘢係咪大家一定要知咧？知咗係咪好咧？咁唔知道又會唔會 miss 好多嘢咧？咁即係呢啲好難好難決定嚇。咁我都頭先聽阿 Jasmine 講，佢哋個 office 都未整好啊，而家咁咧，我都好希望有一日咧可以去拜候下佢哋啦，同埋喺呢度咧就問候阿 Dr. S V Low 啦嚇，佢而家佢一係Genome Institute 嘅 CEO 嚇，咁就我 wish 你哋一個即係 every step of the way 都係 successful 嘅嚇，幫到香港人，幫到中國人，咁我諗呢個係重要。咁咧就要請阿 Brian 咧送台面的紀念品給 Jasmine、
哦、
你的份位一會給你、啊、
Jasmine、啊、多謝你跟我講講書、啊、
多謝
多謝
工
作順利、啊、
剛才有一位陳醫生就、Brian 講了他問了一個很長的問題，我們不在這裡回答了，
我們
回
答
了，我們給一個 email 我們，我們會請 Brian 和 Jasmine、跟進這件事，
沒問題，
好好好，我很希望Brian 和 Jasmine 都短期內又再上來講一些進展給我聽，由這個 Genome Institute， 還有剛才的問題都問得很好的、即我究竟即又有 Genetic Service 又有兩間大學又有 Genome Institute， 其實即我怎樣才可以得到最好的 Advice、啊、還是你們的 Collaboration 是怎樣，我想這個即醫護人員都很想知道，我們希望 One Stop Service 啦，是 Smart Service 啦，這樣最重要是幫到你病人啦，這樣所以、希望你很快的將來又來到這裡跟大家分享你們的工作的進展、心得，這樣
沒問題，
好，多謝了，好，拜拜。